In today's class, I'm going to tell you a lot about the magical world of prototyping. What is prototyping? What tools can be used to make prototypes and how to have lots of fun doing that? This and a lot more in this class. Hey, my name is Tom Biskup and I'm a graphic designer specialized in digital design. You can see my work mostly on my Instagram page at tom.biskup. So check it out. And if you're ready, let's start our class. This is a third lesson in this series. So if you missed the two earlier ones, just make sure you're subscribed at DigitalDesigner.so, so you can get all three. To fully understand what prototyping is, first you need to understand that a website is almost never a single screen. Whether you shop online or you check your tour dates for your favorite band, the experience brought to you by a website is always made with combination of many different screens that follow one after another after another. These screens creating a journey for you, guide you from the moment you land on the site until the moment you reach conversion. Until, for example, you finish a checkout at your favorite store. Reaching conversion, by the way, is the moment when user completes an activity that we want him or her to complete. So a conversion could be, for example, adding a product to cart or signing up for a newsletter. So to reach this conversion, user needs to make a journey between different screens until he or her reaches the conversion. And the overall quality of a digital product that we built, whether it's a website or an app, depends on how smooth this user journey is. And we, the designers, we have to be able to test how smooth this journey is. And it's impossible to test a journey with just a set of static, inactive screens. And that's where prototyping comes into play. To give you a better understanding of what a user journey is, let's try to reverse engineer the user flow in which the conversion is adding a product to cart on the page of this luggage producer, cool brand named Rimowa. I made some screenshots and I pictured the user flow from landing on the page until adding product to cart, and just look how many different variations of different designs are needed to present the whole flow. First, we have a screen where we have only the home page. Then we have a state of hover, which is when user puts a mouse cursor over a product that he's interested in. Then after clicking the product category, user is being presented with a category product listing page, which lists all the products inside a single category. Then user hovers with the mouse over a single product that changes the picture. So again, very minor change, but very crucial for the user experience process. After clicking the product, user is being presented with a separate page, which is called PDP, which is a product description page. And then I assume user would like to change the size of the product as well as the color. So to do that, we need to design a active version of the list that presents all the sizes. And then when the user hovers with the mouse over another size, we need to also design a very subtle change that tells the user that if you click, something will happen. And after clicking, the site reloads and we are being presented with a different product description page of a different product. Then user clicks another color and the page reloads again. Then we have a third product description page with a third product, different size, different color. And then after hovering over add to cart button, it changes its color very slightly. And after clicking it, we have this model box that comes in the form of a sidebar that tells us that in your shopping bag, there is a product. And from here, we can start a checkout process, which would probably result in 20 or 30 more screens from the start of the checkout to the finish of the checkout. And it would have many variants depending on if the user has the account or he has to sign up. So if we wanted to construct a prototype that shows the user flow between landing on the homepage until the product is added to the cart, we need 11 screens to present that in our prototype. So to prototype a user journey like this, a designer has to come up with all the separate screens. And in a design tool like Adobe XD or Figma, then in the prototype mode, we link these screens together so they are clickable, they are interactive, and then launched as a prototype, they act as a coded website instead of a static design. Later in this class, I'm going to show you how to do that. Using this approach makes prototyping a great user experience design tool, because very quickly we can turn static design screens into something that's clickable, that's interactive, and we can quickly test the idea of a user flow. That makes the whole process very agile and cheap for the company, as developers don't have to be included in this process because it's all made within the design team. I'm not a user experience designer, I'm more of a visual thinker. So what I use prototyping in my work for is creating ideas for clever and smooth micro interactions that make small tasks like reloading the pages or browsing through products or reaching navigation quite exciting and fun. Come, let me show you what I mean. Take a look at these two screens. These are two designs, the homepage of a psychotherapy clinic. And what I wanted to prototype here is the transition between the homepage, the hero header of the homepage, to the form where user can make an appointment. And if I wanted to sell this idea to a client, it would be really hard using these static screens because they don't tell a story that I want to tell with the transition between them. Basically, I would have to explain to the client exactly how the transition is about to happen and what's happening during this transition, and I need to count on my client's imagination to follow my explanation, which is a risky thing to do. So this is also where prototyping comes in very handy. When in Figma I switch to prototype mode, I can immediately see that there are some connections made between these two screens. And when I click a connection, I see details of this transition. So basically what it says is when user clicks this button, make an appointment, it takes the user to this screen. And again, when user clicks cancel here, it takes him back to the first screen. Let's see how it works. I will now launch the prototype. And after clicking make an appointment, look what happens. It's a very simple transition, yet really the one that it's almost impossible to explain to the client without just showing the motion and the smoothness of it to the client. It's a clever concept that can be presented only using a prototype. It's also really cool that you can do stuff like that in a design tool like Figma. You don't need any motion design software, and it's pretty easy. So now you know that prototyping can be used either to create a very complex set of screens that guide the user from landing on the website until reaching conversion through a thing called user journey between multiple different screens, or it can focus on micro interaction and providing the feeling of a cool transition between two or three screens. And personally, I love focusing on micro interaction and designing animation and the smooth and clever transition because it gives me a lot of fun. While working as a designer, it's a very important part of your job to make people excited about your designs, to get people on board, accepting and loving the ideas that you present. And let me tell you, there is no better way to present a web design than showing a polished, finished prototype. You can either show this prototype on a meeting and let client play with it, or you can even share it using Figma's share functionality for the prototype. It's just as simple as clicking share prototype and then copying a link to that prototype and sending that link to a client, and then the client will be seeing exactly what we are seeing right now in their web browser, and it's going to be interactive. So there is no excuse for you to present your web design work in the form of static images. It should be a prototype. It should be scrollable, interactive, with some transitions. This is what contemporary web design is all about. To launch a design in prototyping mode, all I need to do is click in the right top corner of Figma, the present button, which will launch the prototype. Now I can see the design. And it's really low effort to create something that will make this design look a little bit more like a coded website. One thing we can do is, for example, we can select a header top bar and then switch to prototype mode in Figma and choose the position from scroll to parent and switch it to fixed, stay in place. And just by doing that, we made this top bar fixed to the top part of the page. And this already looks like a website and not like a static design. I hope you agree. Now, let's say I have a product description page and I want to link the product listing page with the product description page. So after user clicks the product card, the product page loads. To do that, I need to select the product card that I want interactive, then switch to prototype mode. And from now on, I can drag this spaghetti noodle to a screen I want the user to land on. After dragging and dropping this noodle, Figma asks me, what are the details of this interaction? And for now, I will keep it simple and will stay with the default settings. So yeah, that's okay. Let's go to the prototype and see if I click the product now, I'm being transferred to the product description page. So this is our super simple prototype. The transition between these two screens was made using the same technique, although here I've used some sophisticated methods of transition, which is called Smart Animate in Figma. And although this class is a little too short for me to get into details, I will just tell you that while using Smart Animate, Figma inspects the layer names on both screens. And if a layer name matches both screens, Figma creates an automatic transition between them. So if on both of these screens, this section here is called Section 1, and here it's also called Section 1, then Figma creates a smooth transition that is based on scaling this object and making it yellow. And you can see that this is basically exactly what happens. It's getting smaller and it's getting yellow, and that's it. And although what I showed you is prototyping 101, it can get really intense. There is dedicated software on the market that is only for prototyping, and you can get really amazing results while using it. An app that I use sometimes for prototyping is called Principle. And with Principle, you can get really cool transitions and micro interactions. This is a single scroll page made in Principle. It's all prototype without single line of code. And just look what happens when I scroll through this page. Layers overlapping one another, showing up with a nice smooth transition of opacity, overlapping, hiding behind one another. It's really cool what you can do with a dedicated software like that. And this is made without a single line of code, let me just remind you. I hope that after this class, you know a little bit better what prototyping is and how to start thinking about prototyping your designs. It's a very important skill that every digital designer should have. So thanks for reaching the end of this class. Let me just remind you that right now I'm in the middle of preparing a full-scale, comprehensive web design course in which I will take you through the whole process of designing a website from start to finish. We will deep dive into concepts like art direction, user interface design, prototyping, typographic systems, responsive design, just to name a few. The course will be published by Design Practice. It will have a whole community built around it. So I think it might be a really cool thing to join. So if you're interested in that, just make sure you are subscribed at DigitalDesigner.so and we'll let you know when the course launches. So thank you for your time. Hope to see you soon. Happy designing. Bye.